fans were able to come meet their favorite athletes and also participate in other activities like putting on their gear.
I'm with 11 News reporter Lauren Butterfield, who went to the service. Lauren, describe the atmosphere for me there.
Well, of course there was a lot of sorrow, but it was also peaceful. You could feel the love and admiration that the people have for Cody Taus, and the family says it's really helped him get through this hard time.
If you plan to take an infant to a public pool this summer, make sure they're wearing one of these to help keep Utah County pools safe.
Payson City is asking that you only water each area for 15 to 20 minutes on your assigned day. In the newsroom, Lauren Butterfield, 11 News.
Now, Lauren, I know that a lot of cities have some a punishment system in place if you water on the off days. Do they have the same thing in Payson?
Yeah, police are saying if you're watering your lawn too much or on the wrong days, they will give citations.
Great. Thanks, Lauren. I know that funerals and losing a loved one can be hard. What is the family doing to cope?
They say they found a lot of joy by being able to read his blog. In his last post, he quoted Winnie the Pooh, and it says, "If there ever comes a day where we can't be together, keep me in your heart. I'll stay there forever."
Wow.
The search for 22-year-old BYU student Tyler Mail from Northern Colorado began Tuesday morning. Emotions ran high as friends and family heard Mail had not yet returned home from his hike.
Hopefully we find him soon. Hopefully he's up there.
Police and fire officials closed the trail around 1 p.m. on Tuesday so authorities could search the rugged trails.
As he was seen at about 11:30 on Saturday morning, he had a camel pack and he was heading up the trail to the Y. As you know, these mountains are pretty rugged. There's all kinds of cliffs up there, all kinds of things that can go wrong. So yeah, we are concerned at this point.
Augusta says they have helicopters transporting teams of Provost Search and Rescue and mountain rescue teams to the top of the mountain. No sightings of Mel have occurred, but friends and family say they thought he went on a hike in that area.
He was talking with a girl in our ward, just like, "You want to come hike the Y with me? If not, I'm going to go a little bit higher." So that's all I know.
Tyler's friends and family say that he is an experienced hiker and loves the outdoors. Tyler's dad called in Tuesday morning for help and says he didn't call sooner because he didn't think anything was wrong until their son failed to answer calls after 3 days. Augusta says authorities will continue to look for him. BYU fans usually have to travel to see their favorite Cougars, but this year, athletes and coaches brought the fun to fans across Utah. Tyler Hawes is a fan favorite. Kids and parents say he is a positive role model.
There's lots of kids that look up to any athlete as a role model. And you gotta be on good behavior and doing what's right, because those kids look up to you.
Fans formed long lines to get autographs and take pictures with the players from the football, soccer, volleyball, and basketball teams.
Student athletes are really, really good role models. Now, they compete like crazy in the games, but they're really great off the field. They're students first, they're athletes, they're missionaries, they're great kids.
The Cougar Fan Fest is a casual, fun event where parents and children get the chance to interact one-on-one with some of BYU's athletes.
It's fun to see him, call him by name and visit and then just be like a friend.
Cougar athletes say they love to show the fans appreciation for all of their support.
BYU fans were able to come meet their favorite athletes and also participate in other activities like putting on their gear.
The event provided plenty of activities for both kids and parents. BYU supporters say they love the environment created at the Cougar Fan Fest.
Go BYU!
In Spanish Fork, Lauren Butterfield, 11 News. One would expect a fun day on the lake to end in tragedy, but the U.S. Coast Guard says it happens more often than you think. They say that last year they counted 4,500 accidents that involved 650 deaths in recreational boating accidents.
When you're out on a wakeboard or skiing, you have a lot of adrenaline because the boat's going really fast and you want to impress your friends, and yeah, so people have a lot more adrenaline.
Rangers say they want people to enjoy their time on the water while boating, but encourage them to follow the safety guidelines. Some of the cautions include breathing in carbon monoxide from engine vents, which can lead to death.
Basic boating stuff, number one would be check the weather before you go out. With a little bit of wind, the waves can pick up pretty big, and so you just wanna make sure you know what the weather's gonna be like for that day.
The size and length of the boat will determine the safety gear required. Gibson says the most important piece of safety equipment to have on your boat is a life jacket.
I guess I should say 80% of people that have died in boating would not have died if they had been wearing a life jacket. So they really do save lives.
Boating rangers say there are 3 basic navigation rules to keep you safe: proper lookout, safe speed, and keep a safe distance between other boats.
kind of a hard place to be in as a mom, to not be able to save your kid or make them feel better, or, you know, do the things that a mom should be able to do, and I couldn't do that.
There wasn't much Tasha Stevenson could do when doctors diagnosed her baby girl Talia with acute lymphoblastic leukemia cancer, but take the long ride on the terror train.
There were times during the transplant that were just awful, and she was so sick, and it was just painful. I wanted to take the pain away.
To help time pass in the hospital, 5-year-old Talia and her mom would have dance parties, play pranks on the nurses, and decorate her radiation mask.
And it has rainbow and butterflies and that little frog in Maximus, and it says Tangle.
Their struggle had a positive outcome when doctors declared Talia cancer-free.
I'm here because Talia gets to go home from her bone marrow transplant.
Yay! Yay!
More happy news soon came when the Stevensons became pregnant with twins. But her joy took a sudden dark edge when doctors found that Talia's cancer had returned.
Obviously, I was devastated, terrified.
But as it turns out, doctors discovered that one of the 6-month baby twins was a perfect bone marrow match.
She ended up saving my life. She gave me marrow.
Talia's baby sister Tate was groggy and grumpy when she came out of surgery, but the second she saw Talia, she smiled.
I think she knew long before she came here that was something that she was going to do for her sister, so it was pretty special.
Talia calls baby Tate her best friend, and they love playing in their playroom together.
She likes me to hold her, but she's really also squirming. She is fun to play with.
After living in the hospital for more than 5 months, doctors did tests to see if the transplant worked.
She said that the bone marrow results were clear and that she was 100% donor. I don't even know. It's like a feeling I can't describe. I was excited. I was emotional. I was just so beyond happy.
Even though the Stevenson family says this was the hardest thing they've gone through, strangely, they wouldn't change anything because of the growth it brought to their lives.
You can do things you never thought you could do.
In St. George, Lauren Wade, 11 News.